Morning, everyone. It gives me great pleasure to come and share the experience I have early as from 2013 until now. The intention was to have this partnership over a year, but things turned out differently, as I've just told you that we're still together as we are today, as I speak. The journey began in 2013. We were in our old building, our school. Meredith came around, she was in my school, and told me about the program. And I didn't waste time, I grabbed it. And then around October that year, our school was about to be demolished when we were to move to a new school. And then that time we moved and we went into a mobile school at the back of our school. When we came there, we found that the classes that we had were not enough. We could not accommodate our library, we could not accommodate our lab. It was just classes for the learners and two mobiles, one for office, and one was just was more like a staff room, but it was too small to even accommodate our staff. Then there came another time when we had one computer that we linked in, where we received our emails from the department every day, and I was expected to respond to those emails together with my secretary. Then they connected us, they came to change IT people to connect us, and then we did that well, and from there we were able to link and connect with the department through those computers to that connection. And then from there we went to his company, together with SMT, we met his staff, effective staff, and his management. From there we took the whole staff, went there to see the factory, we introduced the staff again, and then there was a team building where everyone was there together with SGP. And then in the next session, we had the startup session where we identified 20 projects actually, and then we agreed that we cannot work on 20 projects. Then from there we prioritized 4 projects. Then reading project was one of them, project language of learning and teaching, arts and culture, supporting learners with learning challenges was those key projects that we prioritized from those projects. Then on the issue of reading project, we have volunteers that you just told me about. Moms from Elkana are coming on Tuesdays and Thursdays to come and support us. The reason for that was the fact that our foundation phase learners are taught in isiXhosa, all the subjects, including mathematics, is taught in isiXhosa, which becomes a problem with their grade 4, because grade 4 they are taught in English. And 3 subjects in foundation phase, it's 9 subjects in intermediate and senior phase. They are all taught in English except isiXhosa, the home language. And we found that there is a big problem because there are results, annual results, annual national assessment results, national tests that we are writing. And then we've also got systemic results that we have that we're expected to perform. We find this a challenge, that our learners are struggling to even read instructions from the papers when they reach grade 6, and the results don't perform well. So the reading project was part of that solution. These moms are coming on Tuesdays and Thursdays. They are supporting grade 200 learners with reading in English as well as in Xhosa. The same story in English, and the same story translated into Xhosa. Because what we found out is that through the research and the workshop that we had at UWC in one of the core meetings, is that learners reach grade 4, when they reach grade 4, their home language, which is isiXhosa, is not fully developed. And that is the time they have to drop the home language and learn English. So through that program, their home language is developed and English, they're also learning English. The launch one, we've got we piloting one class in grade R in English. The intention is to have that class in English in grade 1 until they grade 7, want to see the impact in grade 4, how these learners are going to perform in the test that we're writing every year in grade 3 and grade 6. It is still there because I can see that, you know, it's fighting those tests. But that is the test that is helping us to evaluate how to perform in our schools. So we are still piloting that project in grade R. After 5 years, we'll be able to evaluate how those learners are different to the ones that are learning in this course in all subjects. As Erin told you about arts and culture, learners have been to Elkana with the learners grade 4. We also got trampoline, and then our choir was also given a violin, and also given our choir was also given shoes for learners who could not have shoes. And then our great arts have also been to Elkana this year and last year. On part of the learner challenges, we didn't touch that project yet. We're still coming to that one. Then I've also attended various workshops, leadership workshops, and management workshop, committee of practice, where I was introduced to the books, committee of practice, time to pick. I learned quite a lot there, listening to your staff, and invitation are some of the things that I learned. That we are taught by the department that whenever you're encountering a problem with the staff, you need to charge that person through misconduct, through progressive meetings. But this approach of invitation has introduced me to at times to invite people in and not force them to do things, even if it is a must that they must do. As we speak today, we've got a Year Beyond project in our library through this partnership that is running in our computer lab. These ladies are helping our learners through the online project of numeracy and language in the afternoons together with the World Center. Our learners love this project very much. Every day we've got 100% attendance of learners from grade 1 to grade 4. We don't have problems. We are also planning to have library assistant to assist our library teacher. Unfortunately, we could not get a teacher to be working full time in our library. We had to train one of our teachers to work in the library. So we are planning to have a library to assist the teacher, because the teacher needs a train, and then this person will take over from 3 until 4:30 to help our learners with the projects that we have. I would say, in conclusion, that I've learned that small changes make a big difference in the school. And I've also learned that it is important to welcome people from outside, but you need to know your environment, because you are the one who knows it better than anyone else. I would like to thank everyone who has been part of this journey, and I'm hoping for more things to happen in my school. Thank you.